Hello dear students, welcome to Insta Solution question number 9. So today we have a mathematical type of question here. A patient with IOP of 19 millimeters of mercury who underwent LASIK for a minus 5 diopter of myopia. So what would be her measured IOP after LASIK? So after LASIK, when he comes to me and I want to check his intraocular pressure by a Goldman Applanation tonometer, will the IOP be 19 or will the measured IOP be high or low? So first of all, friends, you should know some basic calculations here in LASIK and how we measure the IOP. So let us see some numerals here. So thickness for the epithelial flap when we are considering a patient should be minimum of 150 to 160 micron. Okay, so this is individually a question. Now when we do LASIK, we do a stromal ablation. So after stromal ablation, the minimal thickness of the stroma left should be minimally 250 to 300 microns. Okay, different surgeons have different opinions, but it is mainly 250 to 300 microns which should be left after LASIK. Now, when you do a stromal ablation, it is like you have to ablate approximately 12 to 15 microns for correction of minus 1 diopter of myopia. So if you want to correct minus 5 diopters, how much should be ablated? How much should be thinned out? Approximately 75 microns, isn't it? Simple mathematics, like for 1 microns, 15 microns, 5 diopters, approximately 75 microns. Now, this is very important. What is the correction factor? So, we have many types of correction factor, but what we commonly use is the Ehlers correction. So, Ehler found that for every 10 microns decrease in thickness of the central cornea, you should subtract 0.7 millimeters of mercury from the calculated IOP on Goldman Applanation tonometer. Now, because Goldman Applanation tonometer has been standardized for approximately 520 microns of the central corneal thickness, you have this standardization earlier. Okay, so this has been standardized for 520 microns as the central corneal thickness. Now, when your central corneal thickness goes down, what will happen? You will have a change of the measured IOP. Now, let us see how we come to know the answer. So, for 10 microns, we have a change of 0.7. So, what will be the change for 75 microns? It would be approximately 4.9 millimeters of mercury, isn't it? So, what will be the answer here? You have to subtract approximately 4.9 or 5 from 19, which comes out to be 14 millimeters of mercury. Okay, so the measured IOP will be less on Goldman Applanation tonometer after you do a LASIK.